the 99%, first of all, they're not you. You are the 1%. You are very different. You are unique, okay? I am unique. You know, the general day-to-day population, especially in the West, in the United States, they don't have habits that are dialed in. But before we even get there, how to really get ahead is you, and only you, in your steps, in your mindset. That's right. I say 100% of this is mindset. You have to believe in yourself. You have to believe in your inner voice, your calling. And you have to make a conscious decision of what you prioritize. You have to make a conscious effort of what your priorities are. And literally write them down. Do an exercise and write it out. Put it, visualize it. Have a vision board, whiteboard, piece of paper. If I were you, I'd use a whiteboard. You've probably seen it in my other videos. Once you have this in front of you, you look at this every day, you think about it, right? It's going to reinforce what's in front of you. It's out of sight, out of mind. And a lot of us are not in the habit of creating a strategy or dialing in habits or having any kind of system in place that enforces your personal self-discipline and your relationship with you. You know, this is by far, first and foremost, extremely important. Your mindset will dictate everything. So I'll tell you a little story. Right now, I'm not supposed to be here, meaning that this walk almost didn't happen. I was stuck inside my apartment condo. It's Sunday. As you can see, it's still beautiful, right? It's amazing now that I'm here. And when I'm doing post-production edits and just simply uploading this video with a few minor tweaks, I'm always looking at, mesmerized at the background. I'm like, how could I not be grateful to be alive and experience the joy of what God and the nature has given us right in my backdrop? This is my backdrop. And you can find your backdrop. So that's another way to look at this, is your adventure, your journey. This is, make it fun. Make it fun. Make it challenging. So actually, walking is not challenging. Walking is very therapeutic. So I almost talked myself out of this walk because I'm so regular at this. And I easily know I can kill 20,000 steps and make it up the next day and keep my average up. But the voice inside me will not let me settle. You know, I am where I'm at because of my habits. I am where I'm at today, and the engine and the switch that drives me is 100% due to the efforts that I put in. Like, this is a no-brainer. Walking for me is a no-brainer. This is my Bible. This is my therapy. Lifting weights is a no-brainer, especially as a Gen Xer. So as you get older, you start to place value on certain things and longevity. Training smart, eating right. Your protein intake, water, sleep, right, recovery, all of the above. These are things we take for granted when we are younger. And unfortunately, as we get older, we start taking a lot of things for granted. And I didn't say this, but a quote that's been floating around, and Kobe Bryant's name has been put on there as the origination, and I could be wrong, but it says, "The greatest mistake we make in life is thinking that we have more time." You know, I am not just a Gen Xer. My 40s are almost behind me. I'm really 50. I'll be 50 next year in July. And I may not obviously look like it because I get carded. Even till today, if I have better sleep right now, I'm just a little tired. But if I clean up and if I'm, you know, groomed, I get ID'd all the time. You know, people treat you differently, and people can smell your habits when you are in the room. People give you more respect. You earn the respect. You don't have to ask for respect. In fact, there is almost no disrespect. And that's the problem. That's the psychology of this, right? Self-improvement journey is the mindset behind it. It's a long game. It's not like you put in 3 months and you're done with the winter arc. You get somewhat of a decent body, and then you freaking go back to where you were before. whatever, you gain your 20 pounds back, 30 pounds back, right? This is life. This is a long game, right? How can you sustain this lifestyle? And 100% has to do with mindset. If you look at the general population, I don't see anyone in the roads that I walk in. I don't see anyone else in this trail that walk and do what I do. That makes me very different. And I know, I'm in Las Vegas, Nevada, and at least on this trail, I'm not. If I saw someone with a gimbal, right, with a carry bag like this, weight bag, and you know, somewhat looking the part of an influencer, you look the part, you look somewhat in shape, I would be saluting and admiring that person. Like, one, he or she don't care about what the people think and the cars passing by looking at you, because what they're projecting by looking at you is something they can't do. They're intrigued. You see the game? They are intrigued by what you are able to do. And trust me, I used to be on the other side looking at people like this, not here, just other areas and geography locations in California. But I've seen people walking around with a gimbal in different parts of Vegas, and some even have it inside a casino. You know, I need to break out of my shell and go more public and deep and figure out that process. But half the time I get struck with copyrights because of the background music in Vegas, the casinos, you know. So, but the fact that I'm even doing this, I'm already ahead of the game. And the fact that I'm pursuing showing up consistently here on YouTube, regardless of the outcome, regardless of no views and the subs, you know, all that is secondary. If I'm going to walk, you know, and if I have, you know, created a system, if I have a you know, habits that are compounding, that's making me the best version of, you know, myself as a Gen Xer, I owe it to myself and then to whoever this may find, is that you can do this too. If I can do this, you can do this too. So the general population typically overeats, are lazy, are obese, and most of them don't believe in themselves. They don't have the self-belief. They don't have the self-belief. They are married to their addictions in that sense. They are absolutely addicted to their bad habits. And let's face it, you know, bad habits are addicting. There's a reason why they call it addiction, right? There's a reason why they call it getting over the addiction, you know. People cannot control their liquor, their alcohol. With that, of course, the combination is horrible eating. So, you know, the biggest danger in all of this is what you put in your mouth, really. Who are you around that's influencing you, right? What are you watching as your pillar, as your, you know, as someone you can mirror your habits? You know, what makes you dangerous in this path is that it's a little uncomfortable, but you have to like the uncomfortable. You have to go towards the discomfort. You have to do the hard things now. And the way you get there is showing up every freaking single day, and in the form of basically self-improvement. That's really it, the mindset behind it. Program your mind to show up every day. What happens over time is there is this massive compounding effect. So you may think and feel, heck, you may not even see any progress like in the mirror, right? But, you know, 30 days of just doing this, you will be a different person, and your energy will shift, your mindset will shift. There's going to be a transformation that takes place, and you won't recognize yourself. So you may actually feel the same. Let me take that back. But other people will start reacting to you. You may lose a few people because all of a sudden you are better than them. You are better. You're not necessarily better in the sense that you're, you know, you have anything special. But can you imagine you showing up every day? You're unbeatable. How can you beat someone who refuses to lose? How? How can you? You have to push past all that negativity, the self-talk, you know, the procrastination, all of that. You have to fight that. You have to put that You have to really psychologically do the deep inner work. And that's what a lot of people don't do, is you have to really have a core foundation, really shut off your vices, Netflix binge watching, porn, alcohol, scrolling on Instagram, scrolling just on the internet. If you're going to scroll, what are you looking at, right? What are you consuming? How does it impact your mindset? And 99% of the people, heck, 90% of the population, I find, is caught up with the cycle, right, of what the masses are already doing. And it's the few that have been able to break away, like myself, that see the higher power, that feel the higher power, that feel the calling from within, that I'm not going to betray myself. So here we are in the winter arc, the most basics of basic things and the fundamentals, like drinking your water, having a good night's rest, self-care, prioritizing protein, sleeping well, right? Of course, I said that. And then this is walking. Document your life. If you want to see your progress, start recording a video from day one and then day 30. You are going to see how you progress, your climb, the steep incline as to your growth, because you're going to catch yourself. You're going to see your mistakes. You're going to see your weaker areas, and you will be inspired to improve upon that. But folks, I'm getting to the tail end of this video here, but not to make this long-winded. This is how you get ahead of 99% of the people, because they're not willing to put in the work. Putting in the work is easy. Showing up day one, day two, day three, for 5 days, it's easy. I think my conclusion is, how do you sustain it now that you're here? You have the motivation, you have the initial adrenaline rush, and you did 20,000 today, but what are you going to do the next day? Can you bring that same energy day four, day five, day 30, right? And if you can't bring that same energy, can you push through it? Can you embrace the discomfort, the fog, the fatigue? Can you push through it, and can a different version of you show up for that day? Because you want to get that day in the books and check it off and turn in that report card for your day. You don't want the stress, the toxins, the chemicals, your hormones shifting or imbalance because you didn't put in the work. And I'm not talking about lifting like a bodybuilder once again. Nothing like that. Just the bare minimum, 10,000 steps. 10,000 steps. You can do it. Think 15 minutes every day, right? 4 15-minute walks. What does it do? You'll get close to 10,000. We're not even talking about your kitchen breaks, your errands, your store runs, right? So always think about doing a little more. Build in these habits. Build in these habits. Write it down. Have a clock. Have a watch. Track your steps. If you don't show up for yourself, you'll be forgotten. And just like that, your story may come to an end sooner than you think it will. Nothing's ever forever. And don't take today, this present moment, for granted. You owe it to yourself to show up. That's how you get ahead of 99% of the people. Till the next one, Mamba out.